Hey everyone and welcome back to my channel Find Inspiration. I hope you all are doing good. In today's video, I am going to share 4 DIYs using deco transfer sheet and decoupage napkin. If you are watching my video for the first time, do not forget to subscribe my channel and hit the bell button to get the notification. So let's get into the video. For the first DIY, here I am going to take this small wooden jewelry box. You can purchase such type of box from Itsy Bitsy, but this box is from my friend who asked me to do some DIY on this. So at first we'll give a coat of gesso or white acrylic color. Here I am taking this deco transfer sheet which I have purchased from Itsy Bitsy. You can buy this transfer sheet from Itsy Bitsy, and to get 5% extra discount you have to use my coupon code. I will mention the code and the link in the description box. Okay, we have already cut a picture from a deco transfer sheet which we have to stick it. Before sticking, you have to remove a plastic layer, then you have to stick it on the base. Stick it nicely and apply some water using a sponge. So once the pictures are visible, you can slowly pull it off and the picture is transferred. So once again, you can see here how I stick the transfer sheet. Slowly pull it off and the picture will get transferred. Leave it to dry for few minutes, then you have to apply Mod Podge glue. Here I am using some chalk paints which is from Itsy Bitsy. So here I am using a flat brush. You can also use dabber to apply the color. To get two different shades, I am using two colors. I am using this deco transfer sheet for the first time for my DIY. And it's very easy to use these deco transfer sheets in any DIYs. So here I am using pink acrylic color for the edges of the box. And using a gold metallic color, I am going to color the latches. Using a dry brush, I will apply the same gold metallic color to the edges. So here we are done with our coloring part, and now I am using this stencil which I have purchased from a local craft shop, and we will apply some texture paste on this, and this is how the design is looking. I am going to repeat the same design on three sides of the box. So now we will beautify our picture using this 3D outliner. This is pearl metallic color. By using that I will make some drops. So once it is completely dry, we have to give a coat of varnish. Finally, I am going to use these pearl stickers which I have purchased from a local craft shop, and will stick it to both the sides of the box. By this, we are done with the work, and here comes the final reveal. The box has turned out so beautifully, and you can keep it on your dressing table to keep some pearls or bangles or any accessories. Okay, now let's move to the second DIY. Here I am using this small MDF cutouts of different shapes, and I have purchased these from a local craft shop. At first, I am going to give a base coat of white acrylic color on all the MDF boards. You can also use gesso as base coat. So they are completely dry now. We'll use this deco transfer sheet from Itsy Bitsy. So I am going to cut these pictures from this transfer sheet according to the size of the MDF board. So let's start sticking these. First you have to remove a plastic layer which is applied on this transfer sheet. Check the position where you have to stick it, then you have to stick it on the base. So apply some water on this paper using a dabber. It's very simple, as in childhood we used to put some tattoos. In the similar way you have to apply the transfer sheet. As you can see, all the images are got transferred. Leave it for few minutes to get dry completely, then you have to apply a coat of Mod Podge. It's very important that you have to apply a coat of Mod Podge so that the picture won't come off and will stick nicely to the base. Once again, I am using these chalk colors from Itsy Bitsy to color the MDF board. You can choose any color of your choice, and instead of chalk paint, you can also use the acrylic colors. So once it is completely dry, here I am going to write some quotes. You can write any quotes of your choice, but here I am writing all the quotes related with plant and gardening. Once we are done with this, I am using gold metallic color to highlight the edges of the MDF board. So now I am going to take this keychain and I'll just fix it inside this hole. You can also use this type of MDF in jewelry making like pendants, but I have used them to make these type of keychains. So finally, you have to give a coat of varnish before fixing the chain. And here comes the final reveal. All has turned out very beautifully, and let me know which one is your favorite in the comment section. Okay, let's move to the third DIY, and I'm going to use this pen stand. Using a sandpaper, I will make the surface smooth. So this is an old pen stand from one of my friend, and she gave it to me to make a DIY on this. Okay, I'm going to use this white acrylic color as a base coat on this pen stand. So dry completely. I'm going to use this decoupage napkin on this pen stand. So you have to tear the napkin. Before that, you have to apply some water using a brush. And always remember to remove the two layers before applying the decoupage napkin. And once again, I'm using the same Mod Podge glue to apply the napkin. So after applying, just place the napkin, and using a dry brush, you have to stick it. Following the same procedure, I'm going to stick the decoupage napkin on all sides of the pen stand. If you don't have Mod Podge glue, you can also use Fevicol glue. The thing is, you have to mix two parts of Fevicol glue and one part of water. Mix it nicely and use it instead of Mod Podge glue. So to apply the decoupage napkin, you have to use a dry brush so that the napkin will not tear. So once it is dried properly, you have to apply a coat of Mod Podge glue. So it's very important, always remember to apply a coat of Mod Podge glue on your work. It will protect your work. And if you are going to color the napkin, the color will not bleed. And now I am going to highlight the pictures which is in the napkin. And fill the empty spaces using the color which matches with the decoupage napkin. And just to give a vintage look, here I am going to use black acrylic color. And using a dabber, I'll just brush it off on the edges of the pen stand. And at last, you have to give a coat of varnish. I use clear varnish purchased from a local hardware shop, and it's going to give a yellowish tinge if you apply it on a white surface. So here comes the final reveal. And here comes the fourth DIY. Here I'm using these four MDF boards which I have purchased from a local craft shop. At first I'm going to give a white acrylic color as a base coat. And once again, I am going to use this decoupage napkin from Itsy Bitsy. So let's tear the napkin according to the size of the MDF board. Using Mod Podge glue, you have to apply the decoupage napkin. Remove the two layers of the decoupage napkin, then you have to stick it using a dry brush. So just make sure you won't get any wrinkles. You can remove the extra napkin using a sandpaper, but I am going to stick it to the edges. Okay, once it is drying means you have to apply a coat of Mod Podge glue. And now I will highlight the pictures using some acrylic colors. And finally give a coat of varnish. Okay, that's it for today. If you like this video, click the like button. Share the video with your family and friends. And do not forget to subscribe my channel and hit the bell button to get the notification whenever I upload a new video. And here comes the final reveal. Our beautiful coasters are ready. See you soon with one more interesting video. Till then, take care and bye-bye.